Okay, it's September 9th, 2016. It's 6:20 p.m. I'm out here cutting this okra off. Probably gonna cut this down tomorrow. I don't know if you can see the size of it to a knife. That's about 6.5 inches. All the big ones I'm taking off. The little ones I'm feeding the dogs because it's really good. It's very healthy for me too, but you know, I was giving it to them for snacks. See these red ones, say about 8 inches, some of these. They're as short as 6 inches, I'd say, and as long as about 9 or 10 inches, maybe. This is kind of tough with the knife's not as sharp as it should be. But again, you can look at this one here. Let me show you. It's longer than the knife, see? So this is about 9 or 10 inches long. And I got a bucket over here, a 5 gallon bucket. I'll probably end up cutting more off tomorrow. I'm not gonna come off tonight, evidently. But you can see all of these. You know, these are big. These are big okras. These I'm gonna let dry out and they're gonna be seeds, and you get like about 50 or 100 seeds in each one of those. And as you can see, they grow and they keep growing. September 9th right now. I mean October 9th, not September, October 9th. Tonight's the date that the entertainment of the, what do they call it, thing? That town hall debate thingy. Yeah, that's not going to be scripted at all. It's the bad guys' time to lose tonight. The good guys lost last time. The bad guys are going to lose tonight. And then there's the third one for more excitement. Yeah. Because it's not fixed or rigged at all. It's all real, folks. They keep saying every single year, this time it's going to be different. This time. So, you know, after like the 12th time, and now it's just stupid. But look at the okra. It's bare. Like, there's that one pop there. There was a couple of these. I had like 3 pods. Like, see that one right there? There's 2 or 3 pods up at the top. Zoom in and zoom back out a little bit so it'll focus. It'll focus for you to see it. Those are green okra pods. On the viewfinder, I can't, it's just a shadow, so I can't, you know, if you see it that way. There's a big green one right there, but this guy, wow, I don't see any okra pods. Look how tall that is with leaves up at the top. But you see that one with double to them. That was about 6.5 inches. They're around 6 inches right there. Where is it? Let me see if I can get right there, those. That one up there is almost 7 inches. That red one, if I can find it down here, right there. Like I say, I'm going to cut off a bunch of these. I'm not going to get all of them, but it'll be close to half a bucket here tonight because I'm itching to wear long sleeves when you're out on okra. I swear, it's the, I don't know, the fuzz that's on it. It makes you itch really bad. It's a protection thing for nature, I guess. But you can eat the smaller ones. This is real small. This one I give to my dog, you know, it's too small, really. Give him about 3 inches or so, so long. About the size of that knife blade or even shorter is a good size. You can eat them raw and they're very, very nutritious. So, I mean, out in the summer, I come out here and I pop off one for me. I give one for each of the dogs. Sometimes my wife would eat one, then I'd eat another one. You know, and then still be picking them too. So right here, average size. Right there, that's about 4 inches. Okay, that one's gonna be, I'm gonna cut it off, take it in the house. Or I'll give that to the dog. I'll cut it up in pieces for the dogs. But these big ones here on this outer row here, I'm gonna try getting all these off. You see how close they are and everything. So next year we're gonna plant them in the back. We'll have 2 rows of 1, 3, maybe 5, or 3 rows of 4. All the way over there, the plastic will be cut, so it'll be missing in the middle, just like there's a middle right here. We're gonna do a middle right up in there too. The beans will be all the way to the left, tomatoes will be up here. So. See, now look at the back plants even. See, I put like 5 okras around the edge of the garden in the back there. You can see how big those are too. See how big those things are? Those are like 6 and 7 inches right there on that one. I mean, they're all back there. Yeah. 2 of them right there. There's a red okra and a green. Green okra, green okra, green okra, green okra, 3 green okra, green okra right there on the end there. So, now you know. The good nutritious vegetable, very nutritious, full of a lot of vitamins and such. My tomatoes now, there's a nice green one. The green right there. The green one right there. I had one hornworm on here, which I got off yesterday, and I sliced it in half. And I got one in the back here. And a wasp got to it and does what a wasp does. Lays its eggs on it. It's a it's parasitical now. I don't know if it's still out here. I didn't cut it off. I figured let it die like nature. With those little parasites all over them. I don't remember where I saw it either, but I just looked down and I saw a green worm and it had white dots all over it. And see, I was using these tomato sticks, these tomato cages, but the wind has been so bad out here. I just stand them upside down and put the branches in them to keep them off the ground, because see, there's a couple small tomatoes right there even. Right there. I don't see much of the others out here. I don't see that worm. Oh, there's a tomato too. Tomato right there. And one back there. So, you know, it's September now. If these are if it doesn't get cold for 2 more weeks or so, I'm taking these green tomatoes in the house. A couple of them I might let go to ripe if they get big enough. The rest of them are going to be fried green tomatoes. There's one right there. That's my kale. I got three in there. I should only have one in there, or two at the very most, but there's three in there. And this is chard. See, I got a tomato growing in here on this branch right here. So I just got rested inside here for the weight. But I got chard in there. Well, I don't remember where the worm was at. I'll just show you what they look like. It's got like a bunch of, looks like a bunch of white, like pieces of rice on the body of the worm. And what it is, there's a larva for the wasp. They feed off of that worm. It kills the worm. It was eating some of the branches and all that. I just let it stay for right. Ain't gonna do nothing now. It's dead. It'll die off in probably a day, if that long, while it feeds off of it. So it might have fallen off already and crawled away. But it was on a branch. So I don't see anything out here right now. They cut down all the toxic cotton except across the road. You got about 120 acres across the road they gotta cut. They'll probably do that Monday, tomorrow. And gosh, I've been feeling like crap for like the last 2 weeks, 3 weeks. And I've been walking my dog a lot, Petey, twice a day. And ever since I've been doing that, I've actually been feeling worse. And coughing like crazy, like I got something caught in my throat and I can't get it completely coughed out. Like a scratchy throat. So, and you know, I'm sorry, call me paranoid, call me whatever the hell you want, I don't give a shit. But I'm blaming it on the chemtrails and the toxic stuff that's surrounding our house here. So, yeah, there's some green tomatoes on here. I threw one off that was on here for a long time. It was green, it had a couple holes in there, but that's why I come out here and I check them with my hand. Usually I put my hands all the way around them, make sure that they're okay. See, this one's got like lines on it right here. That's a sign of like not getting enough water. That can't be true, because I've been giving it water every 4 days, 3 days, soaking down here for a half hour, soaking so there's puddles everywhere. And now I do have holes all through the plastic, not just the holes where the plants are at. That's what I had originally done, and that's not letting enough water get into the soil. So I've been taking my knife, and wherever there was puddles, I was just stabbing all the way around, like this here. Stab all the way around it, and I'd stab in the middle and everything else for water to go down and all around the plants, so that the plastic was not holding back any water. Black-eyed peas. I got a couple, one or two purple hull peas that aren't growing worth a damn right now, but still. And those watermelon, whatever. Those will probably be tore up. I'm gonna stop recording. I'm gonna get this first row of. Like I said, like this right here, this is two different plants. This is the one in the first row. That's about 5 inches long. There's two on that one there, bent over. No, that's not the same plant here. Yeah, because look at it. You see how thick it is, like a tree branch? It comes up here. Up there's one, and it goes up here. And this one here that's bent over, these are all on this first plant. So let me stop recording this and put them all in the bottom here, and then tomorrow these will all be pulled up. We have to saw them off first. It'd be nice to have an electric saw. I don't have any electric saws. So I'm gonna cut up 1, 2, 3, 4. But again, look at that, it's like a tree. I use my axe out here. I got like a tree axe out here to cut it. So let me shut this off and get this thing filled up a little bit.